This video was produced as a requirement in ENS 201 Ecosystem Structure and Dynamics, submitted to Dr. Mark Dondi Arboleda. This short lecture is about the introduction of exotic species, a threat to Philippine biodiversity. What comes to your mind when you hear the word exotic species? Alien? Non-native? Introduced? Invasive, threat, and many more. Yes, all of this refers to exotic species. Opposite of it are native species, which are original species, indigenous to the area, are naturally occurring. But take note that although all invasive species are exotic, not all exotic species are invasive. So, what are exotic species? These are species that occur outside their natural or native range of distribution. They might have arrived in a new habitat by human activity, accidentally or intentionally introduced for food or other purposes. However, these introduced species usually do not have predators in their new environment, and they compete with the original species for food and space. Hence, although many believe that not all exotic species have negative impacts, biologists are still alarmed by the fact that some may have unknown threats due to lack of study, given that these invasives may displace our native species. Some exotic species are considered for their advantages, like most reforestation programs in the Philippines that plants gymelina and mahogany because they are fast-growing. Yet, their disadvantages are often overlooked. These plants may compete with our indigenous species that provides food and shelter for particular species of plants and animals that may lead to decline or even extinction of our native species. Other exotic species in the Philippines are introduced for economic purposes, such as oil palm and rubber tree. However, it doesn't account for the environmental cost of these monoculture farms that displaced our valuable forest and productive lands that serves as habitat for diverse species of wildlife and source of our food. We haven't also considered the potential pests and diseases that it may brought along and that they deplete our soil nutrients. Another issue is that the clamor of some farmers and land owners, like in Palawan, that they were tricked into giving their land away for lease to oil palm companies with support of the government, but the farmers loses all their rights to their land, never receive any money, and saddled with debt. Another group of exotic plants common in the Philippines are those that we use in landscaping. We kept on trying to make our hotels and parks to look foreign by introducing exotic species, which provides aesthetics, but drives butterflies, birds, and other native wildlife away. In fact, we also have lots of beautiful native plants that can be used for landscaping our homes and urban areas, and at the same time can serve as wildlife habitat and corridors. Euphorbia and welcome plant had also been in demand for home landscaping for some time, but eventually, many are disposing them because of their poison and toxic components. The water hyacinth, or known as water lily in the Philippines, is nice to look at, but their presence in most of our aquatic ecosystems had become a problem. This introduced ornamental plant is now invading and blocking most freshwater lakes in the Philippines, and their excessive growth threatens the survival of native plants and animals. Exotic species are not only in terrestrial habitats, we also have lots in our aquatic ecosystems. According to Guerrero 2014, the Philippines has 62 species of introduced freshwater fish from 1905 to 2013. They are introduced intentionally or accidentally for aquaculture, ornamental purpose, recreational fishing, and mosquito control. Some of the most famous are the knife fish in Laguna Lake, the janitor fish in Marikina River and other adjacent water bodies, and the Nile tilapia all over the Philippines, which were cultured for food but can already be found in different aquatic ecosystems. Other exotic species include golden kokol, which are introduced for food. The big house rats that are pests, which might have been accidentally introduced through cargo ships. And the big Chinese bullfrog that, according to some farmers in southern Palawan, this species doesn't only eat insects, but they also eat smaller native frog species. Hence, this disrupts the natural food chain and threatens our native species. Although, there are no detailed studies yet that have been conducted to prove it. In Jesmus et al., 2006, they have listed 5 invasive introduced frog species, which include Hoplobatrachus. In the study of C, 2014, 35 species of exotic amphibians were recorded in 235 pet shops in Manila, Cebu, and Davao, and some of it, such as the 4 pictures above, are already in the wild and recorded by Jesmus et al., 2006, as invasive species. While the pictures below are just some examples of other species in pet trade that may also pose threat of accidental introduction. Hence, the list of exotic and invasive species will continue to increase through time if we will not learn from our mistakes, if we will not stop introducing new species, if we will continue to patronize exotic pet trade, and if we will not control the already existing population of exotic species in the wild. Philippines is naturally rich in biodiversity. We are considered 5th among the 17 megadiverse countries in the world, which means we have more than 70% of the world's biodiversity. Yet, being a developing country, we are also facing the highest threats of losing this megadiversity. One of the threats is the introduction of exotic species. So, we have to understand that we are not adding to the Philippine biodiversity when we introduce new species, but rather we place our rich biodiversity at stake of extinction. Let us help in maintaining the integrity of the genetic, species, and ecosystem diversity of the Philippines. I would like to thank the authors of my references and the owners of the pictures that I used, including those with unknown sources. Thank you for the background music, Tingnan Nyo by Joey Ayala.